One thing about billionaires is they're not trying to give it away. Mm-hmm. They're not trying to give it away at all.
Let me say this. First of all, I'm not taking a position as to whether they should or should not sign because I'm not a player and I don't know what you know. Let me give you the information that's been given to me and then let y'all know what's been said before I said anything else. 17 games, $5 billion over 10 years. Minimum salaries will increase 17.6%.
Yep.
Practices will be limited during the offseason and training camp. Players will receive 48.5% in the deal. Also, not just one bye week, two bye weeks, plus less practices, plus less contact, plus less off-season commitments.
Yes.
And that minimum players will be taken care of and retired players will be taken care of. That's what I've been told. Based on that, here's what I would say to the players. You ready to strike? Are you ready to hold out? Because, see, what we got to stop doing is pacifying some of these young dudes who want to stick out their chest, getting on video, talking about, I got you. Don't worry about it. We ain't going to let y'all down. We're going to stand up for y'all. You sure about that? There's 1,696 players on opening day.
Yeah.
Okay? In the NFL, when we talk about dudes getting paid real money, I'm talking about the kind of money where you could afford to miss an entire season or two seasons. You couldn't come up with 200 players that could afford to do that. One would argue. So what I'm saying to you is this. We're talking about anywhere from 1,300 to 1,500 players.
Absolutely.
That's going to need that money. Are you ready? I'm not taking a position because I lead the players.
I get it. I understand.
But to the players out there, I'm asking a simple question. Are you ready to skip the season? Because here's what I have been told. If the players don't take this deal, it ain't getting any better.
No.
The coronavirus, that's one thing.
Yep.
Also, television contracts coming up, et cetera, et cetera. The owner's attitude is, we giving up more than we want to right now. It will not get better if you don't take this deal. That's all I've been told.
And if you go back to like 19, I think it was 87 when the last strike happened, people like Joe Montana crossed the picket line because his mama's sitting at home saying, we missing checks.
And the ratings went down about 15%.
So, you know, at the end of the day, I understand that the Aaron Rodgers of the world and the J.J. Watts and some of the bigger players, but when you start missing them checks as big players, you're going to start to think different.
Here's the thing. The NFL operates a de facto monopoly. There's no other real game in town that's paying the money. So because of that, they have enormous leverage.
Isn't that all of them, though?
Dealing with the players.
Major League Baseball, right?
All the major leagues, But at least in basketball, you can go make millions of dollars overseas if you really are willing to do that.
Well, you can go to the XFL now. There are options.
Yeah, there's no money in the XFL.
And the CFL.
But the point is this.
Ain't no money.
There's no money. We're talking about where the big money is. Mm-hmm. So if you're one of the best in the world, you worked your whole life for it, that's who's going to pay you. Mm-hmm. They have an enormous advantage in labor in negotiations. So they've capped labor costs. Everyone wants to control labor costs, and they've done it. 48.4, why should there be any cap on what percentage the players make? They should be able to make whatever people are willing to pay them, but they've artificially capped it. Jerry Jones helped lead that charge, you know, 25 years ago. That's one advantage they have. Here's the other advantage. They can always divide and conquer the labor union because NFL players are a diverse group, especially economically. Key, you pointed it out. The average career is only about 3 years.
Yeah.
Those guys are not making big money. It sounds big to the working man, but that's their lottery ticket that they've worked their whole life for, by the way. And that's it. That's the money they're going to see above and beyond what working people see. 3 years of money. If you address them, the rank and file, they have by far more votes than anybody else, right?
Yeah.
So the upper echelon players who are like, but wait a minute, why are we capped at all and can get into the more kind of nuanced business of the negotiation are going to be outmatched. So I'm not saying you're wrong, don't take the deal. They probably should take the deal. But I understand the position of players saying they have a monopoly and they can divide and conquer.
I understand the deal. I've been following the whole thing. I get it. But I also understand that guy that makes $2 million gross over the next 3 years that is going to be out of the league in August of 2022.
Better protect that 800 G's you're netting out.
That's all I'm saying. So in order to be able to do that, this is an opportunity for you to do it,
right,
along with those benefits.
That's why they're going to wind up passing the deal.
Let me say something somewhat controversial. I know what a great businessman you are, not just a football analyst. And you, I know how smart you are. And not only that, you were talking to me about your concerns, Max, if I recall correctly, about the economy. Because while everybody's out there raving about the economy, you were like, hold your horses here. That ain't so great. What do owners care about? They care about now. They care about the economy. I think they care about the economy more. You know, I wouldn't say I think. Let me rephrase that. I've been told by folks in the NFL, you know, the virus is something that they're concerned about, but they're also concerned about the economy. Also, they're concerned about, excuse me, what if there's a different administration in the White House a year from now? Excuse me, how do we anticipate the economy will be affected by that? They take all of these things into consideration and make the point, you better take this deal now, because it ain't going to get any better. I think the NFL players, I'm not saying this, I do think it's important that the NFL players out there hear that, because that way you make the decision understanding the risk that you take.
They need to get all the information. There's no question about it. At the end of the day, could you get a little bit more out of it? If you're willing to take the risk, maybe you can. Maybe you can. But if you go into 2021 and there's a stoppage, you know, I understand the NFLPA has put some money away over the last several years.
They ain't put that much money away.
I can promise you that.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.